Welcome to Reykjavik Iceland again for our visit to the supermarket called Bonus. This is like the, well, probably the most cheapest supermarket in Iceland, and they are all over, and we're gonna check them out. Please don't be shy in asking me any questions. I receive your comments about, I think it's about 30 seconds after you post them, so 30, 46 seconds. So, I checked out if they had Wi-Fi here, and of course they don't, so maybe there will be a little bit of stuttering, who knows. It's a sunny day in Reykjavik. You can feel spring is in the air, but there's always some kind of an Easter, we call it Páskahret, or Easter snow or Easter bad weather. So there will probably be bad weather in a couple of days, couple of weeks. But yeah, let's go inside. And hi Ayla, hi Kathy and Julie and Nigar and John. Nigar Hajjeve. Okay, it's very hard for me to pronounce your name, Nigar. Hi, TV. It was not the N-word, sorry. So let's head in. Hi Sherry. Is it true that grocery stores sell yarn? Yes, some do, but not all. Depends on the location. If it's a small grocery store in a small town, yes, probably. I've mentioned this before. This is a Christmas specialty called Mast og Appelsin. This is a mixture of two drinks, and this is like our Christmas drink here, and very traditional for that. So just 200 kronas for half a liter of that. That's roughly $1.5, something like that. Hi Jocelyn, hi John. Basics, milk, bread, coffee. So some bread here. This is a very traditional thing, carrot cake. Do you have that back home? Carrot cake?
Hello.
Of course you have. Kleinur. Somebody is interested in some kleinur. Where do we have them? This is not my usual grocery store, so I usually go in another place, but they are unfortunately like in a bunker, so forth. So I saw that one was mentioning pastry. We have muffins, cinnamon rolls, like small cinnamon rolls. Maybe some of you saw my video about the cinnamon rolls earlier. Okay, here we have them. Kleinur. This is like our donuts. So twisted donut. Delicious thing. Only about 560. So that's $3 for you. No, $4. 15 pieces. So relatively not too expensive. Hi Jennifer and Valerie, what's the Coke prices? Okay. I think it's the same price. I'm not sure. Hmm. let's check inside where the so this is like for the cinnamon rolls, like glazing and brown glazing and pink glazing, so you could put that on the cinnamon rolls. So you don't have to make that on your own. Hi Claire. No, I don't think we have adult toys in the store here. I haven't seen it at least. Not seen it at least. This is a very popular thing with my boys. It's a Swedish giflar. This is also cinnamon buns or... Yeah, we do a lot of importing here in Iceland, unfortunately. So, for example, for COVID, prices have been getting higher for a whole lot of things. This is, of course, our beautiful brown rice sweet bread. I like to buy it like in a pack like this. I have to cook it for you sometimes and maybe make a recipe. So a little bit of butter, cheese, beautiful. And this is something that I always have in my back home. These wafer thin rye bread cakes. And this is perfect for example, if you're going for a drive around the Golden Circle or Ring Road or whatever. Like a perfect thing to have like this, and some Icelandic butter, and maybe cheese, and maybe like a smoked hangi kjøtt, smoked leg of lamb, like in thin slices. I'll try to show you to later on. Perfect thing to have. For example, because of COVID, a lot of dry goods like biscuits and wheat and all kinds of dry goods, the prices for them have been going up for about 12.5% in Iceland since the start of COVID. So all kinds of dry goods are... Hi, Jocelyn. Yes, that's the same in Fontana Spa, the rye bread. Same that they make in the pans for Fontana. So all kinds of juices. Orange juice has been gone up about 7% since COVID started. Like prices for orange juices and stuff like that. So, it's 240 kronas for a can of Coke. That's about $2. I'm trying to locate something uniquely Icelandic, of course. Oh, they have started again, these hackers. Ignore the links. You've learned that by now. Ignore the links. So, yeah, ham. And so this is the thing I was talking about, the smoked, like thin slices to put with the rye, the thin rye bread that I showed you earlier, flat cakes, rye bread flat cakes. So this is the perfect thing to have, like a pack of this. Where do we have it? No. Yes. So like a pack of this and a couple of these rye bread thin cakes, and you put that with the butter, and it's perfect like picnic for hikes and stuff like that.
Come on, Mr. Gilbert, let's get coffee.
Yes, I will show the fish. Meats are quite expensive, Marla, yes. I'll show you to you a little bit later on. Rófustappa, basically rúrabaga. And you put that with your thorri food, the food that we have this traditional between middle of January to middle of February. This is like a traditional for this season. And what kind of tuna salad, shrimp salad, hangikjöt salad. This is my favorite, on top of bread. This is like made with a smoked leg of lamb meat that I showed you. Hi Chris and Sarah. No RC Cola. That finished about probably 15 years ago, something like that. This is a little bit of a unique thing. Remoulade with capers and herbs and now for the hot dogs, of course. You put this on the hot dogs. Pretty unique thing. You're mixing mayo together. This is, we believe that this is a unique. Perfect, for example. My boys love this. Kaiva. This is basically liver pate. And my boys love this. Pate on top. Unique. Het cheese. Basically, wipe a jam, perfect with some now. This is like a leg of lamb, smoked leg of lamb. This is twice smoked. This is probably the worst because they have the coolers here. They split up the connection. So this is liver pudding. We have also blood pudding somewhere here. Yeah, it's down there. Blood pudding. That's the red one. And this is something of our Celtic heritage, like similar like in the British Isles, like this. So I know the connection is much better here. When I'm inside the, fridge, it's of course like a bunker. So yeah, there's a little bit of an interference there. So of course this is a favorite of my boys. Some Cheerios. Many vegans, yes, and it's a growing thing, people, and a lot of great restaurants for vegan. Yes, chicken is a very common food, like the most common meat today. But it wasn't until the 1980s, something like that. You see the price for a pack is 2,000 kronos. So that's around 13, 14 dollars, euros. So the Sirius, John is asking how much are they? That's 660 for a pack. And of course, you don't have to spend a lot of money if you want when you're driving the ring road. You can of course stock up in places like Bonus and things like that. Things like frozen food have been gone up about 7% also in Iceland since COVID started. Yes, Manda, some food items are, you know, not that more expensive in Iceland. This is all kind of frozen food, very I want to show you this one, of course. So now they're stocking up chocolate eggs for Easter. All kinds of caramel, licorice. This is chocolate licorice together, of course, here. This is like pepper-filled licorice. Dark chocolate. Salt caramel chocolate egg. So these are for Easter here. All kinds of, so everybody gets an Easter egg for before Easter. Of course. And some eat more than one. Not mentioning any name. So you see, this is a very particular chocolate bar called Eitzet. So this is one of the Christmas foods that we have here, called ptarmigan. This is a Scottish one, I believe, or British, but we hunt them here also, ptarmigan. This is a particular Christmas food. No, there's no coupons here. I was asking that. Okay, I didn't see that, but there are no coupons in Iceland. No such thing. So I'll try the freezer after a while again, but it will break up. I'm going to show you some candy, some unique Icelandic candy. Some popcorn, and I'm of course trying to not to record people, so that's why I'm sometimes making very close-ups of food items. So these are all kinds of imported goods you'd find in anywhere. Yes, masks are mandatory if you're in grocery stores like this, and stores basically. So let's check out some candy. That's a particular favorite of mine, Streimr. This is like a chocolate with licorice filling and we are one of three countries in the world that combine this, like licorice and chocolate together. And this is another one called djúpur, sugary coating, chocolate, and then licorice inside. Laura is asking, do we get Utz or Snyder snack foods? No, don't remember that. That's another particular fun. One of the most sold Icelandic candy called Thristur. This is also like chocolate, now mixed with a little bit of a salmiak outside, coated. Peppery salmiak, it's lovely. Salt caramel, something that you have to try when you go to Iceland. You have to try this combination of licorice and chocolate together. Some people have been asking me about this, hraun. This is lava. As you see, it's very like the lava stones. So that very, very common thing. This is one of the biggest brands of candy in Iceland, Goa. And we are crazy about licorice, of course. All kinds of licorice. And Prince Polo, this is like one of the version of the... This is a very traditional candy bar, like a waiver bar in Iceland. Gained its notoriety in, like, I think 1970, something like that. And this is, of course, also a traditional thing called opal, like licorice. This is the candy that I showed you earlier that's been made into a Easter egg. I do agree, Jill. Icelandic licorice is the best. It's very hard for me to get some licorice anywhere else.
So you know what's the must try?
Yes, yeah, I showed them earlier. Yes, everybody agrees with this one. You have to try this one. Most popular candy in probably in Iceland. Yeah, milk chocolate, licorice pieces, a little bit of caramel. Yes, we put almonds in chocolate bars. Oh, it's back. This is my favorite, like soft licorice with a... Oh, this is... I have to buy a couple of those. Sometimes not available. Let's pan away. Do you see something original here? Not so. All kinds of refrigerating. Hi Jan, yeah, they think I'm a strange man talking to myself. This is, of course, a bit strange to be constantly talking to myself, but I think I'm getting used to it. I'll go into the refrigerator now, or the fridge part again a little bit later on, but so things like vegetables and fruit have gone up really, really much since COVID started. Like I think 13%. So a kilo is about $3. How is that for you? $3 for a kilo of lemons. Fortunately, we can grow some things in our greenhouses. We grow like you can see the sign here, Icelandic vegetables. So they are grown in greenhouses. We grow all things that need a lot of electricity and water. We can grow them in greenhouses. So like tomatoes, bell peppers, cucumbers, kale, and stuff like that, all grown here. And of course our potatoes, that's one of the things that, of course, root vegetables is one of the things that can grow here in the barren soil of Iceland. So these are all Icelandic products here, all grown in greenhouses. Debbie is asking, are the greenhouses geothermal? Yes, they are. All houses, most, like 99% of all, is in greenhouses. And they are heated up with geothermal energy and using the cheap electricity and cheap water that we have. Yes, Pat, they have even grown bananas, but they're a bit tricky, and so it's not mass produced. Of course, you know that our local snaps, brennivín, is made with the Icelandic potatoes, fermented potatoes. I'm thinking about visiting a tomato farm, actually, doing a live stream from a tomato farm and restaurant. Things like strawberries are quite priced high here. Kind of blueberries, $879, that's $6 for a small pack. How much are eggs? Did I pass eggs? I will check, Don, how much are eggs? Yes, Stephen, they make tomato beer in the Friðheimar farm that I'm hoping to visit sometime soon. So things like I said, all things dried goods are quite priced, high priced in Iceland. We're of course crazy about ice cream. So a pack of ice cream, 1.3 liters, about 750 kroners. $5, 5 euros. Justine, Costco is priced lower than Bonus in many items, but of course you need to buy like huge quantities. But for common items, they are sometimes higher. So this is a vanilla chocolate, pecan nuts, and salt caramel and all kinds of stuff. Yes, of course we have rapapara sulta pirita. Paulina, never, never buy water in Iceland. We have the purest water in the world. Loose volcanic soil is a natural filtration system. So never buy water. So pirita, rapapara sulta, rhubarb jam. Oh, how much? This is an Icelandic product, right? Yes. $450, $3. Yes, Svið, I need to go into the cooler. And unfortunately, I will maybe break up when I go there, so I want to do it when I'm finished, or at the end. So, nothing uniquely Iceland, everything imported here. Everything imported. So always just bring your water, like a container, and just drink water, like fill it up. Never buy bottled water in Iceland. That's a sham. So these are very popular here. Lamb shanks. My father loves them so they have lamb shank communities where they meet up and eat these kind of lamb shanks. So it's like a ritual thing. Again, we have big containers of liver pudding. These are made each fall. I would love to do a live stream where we make these liver pudding for you. That's like a meat for kjötsupa. Like you do a bag for that. Joan, do you eat as much snack food as we do in the US? Yes, I would guess so. Many do, but it's depends on who you're talking to. This is a very good dish. I'm gonna post the recipe for this lamb rack. Or I'm not sure. Maybe we have already done it. Lamb fillet. This is a very traditional bag you would buy for the Icelandic lamb soup. You would buy a bag like this, and that's one that's for the kjötsupa. So this is a perfect, you know, buy one bag and then a large pot, and I'll maybe do a live stream cooking kjötsupa or do a video for you. I'm not sure if I trust myself to do it live. So this is like the bag that you would buy for kjötsupa. So if you're traveling to Iceland, this is a perfect thing to grab and do one night. Of course we have the best hot dogs in the world, Pat. That's not a question. They are mostly made out of lamb. But of course the unique condiments are also a factor in. So this is the leg of lamb. This is a perfect Sunday steak for us, for the family. Of course, salmon and trout is a perfect thing to have here in Iceland. Very relatively cheap and delicious. This is cod, frozen cod, frozen haddock. This is Arctic char over here. And salted cod. You know, some people love the salted cod, like the bacalao and things like that. I love to make this back home, the fish balls. I've posted a video about that. The favorite flat cooker, Pirita, is of course, it's from a company called HP. Don't buy them from Bonus. They are not good enough. So, some lobster and shrimps, lobster soup. Hi Molly, yes, the trout is local. You're not the only one, Jan, that loves bacalao. Of course, Spain and Portugal rely heavily on the Icelandic cod for their bacalao. One of the most exported things. Iceland cod is of course our most common fish that we export. So what do we have here? Some imported meats. Are we breaking up? Hi Michelle, yes we have a fresh fish market, but usually it's this is lamb liver. Some people love that. Lamb liver over here. Yes, we only have hey Jonah. Yes, we have only reusable grocery bags now. There's a law that you can't have plastic bags anymore. I'm at the one in Skavan, Alan. I'm at the Bonus in Skavan. Most popular fish is probably cod, but haddock is probably the most used one. Did I forget to post the price for the lamb? No, okay. So you're thinking about what kind of leg of lamb? So it's 13, sorry, focus. It's 1300 kronas for the kilo. And so what? That's $9 for the kilo, $10, but of course that's frozen. Hi Peter, yes, I have tried Canadian Atlantic lobsters. And yes, because the Icelandic lobster is actually a langoustine, so it's a smaller lobster. Yanis asks, is online shopping home delivery popular? Yes, it's a growing thing, and especially after COVID started. Yes, Monique, they have like smoked lamb. I was showing it earlier, maybe. But I'm going to go into the freezer again. So if I stuttering. Yes, for frozen Sheridan, for the lack of lamb. For the not frozen, it's much. It's like 4,000 something like that. Yeah, we're talking about the langoustine. So the langoustine is smaller, and it's more condensed, and I think the flavor is a little bit better. Like honky cut. Coffee is 1,000, so like $9. Yeah, the cheese selection. But then you'll have to so I want to show you some fast food. You can buy kjötsúpa, like Icelandic lamb soup, just like in a 1 kilo for about lamb skank, lamb shank, shank, skank. Sorry about that. Rice pudding, pork porridge, and. No cheap like meats are important. Bonus. Well, that's fair. Off one half a liter, 313 the sugar. There's not a lot. There are some blue cheeses and blue and white mold cheese called Demon. This is the classic one. The Camembert. Said we don't have a lot of like selection of good cheeses in a place like this. There are some here, Gouda and Kuri. Roast teriyaki chicken. And then some. chili con carne to... meat. Garlic and pepper. Basically the same of several more expensive for our so here we have varieties. Hi Diane, yes, it's a of course, perfect. Stephen was talking about this one. So, hi, Pirita. Yes, there's Flora. Here we have some Arctic char. Lobster sauce. Lobster fillets and bread. Para. Trout. But usually not in this kind of place. This one, Surkvalur, so sour whale, so this is fin whale. So just for you guys that were watching my broadcast live stream from yesterday. Can I offer you some sour whale blubber? No? Yes? Sour whale blubber? Anyone? Any takers? And we're pretty, I think we've covered most of like a live I'll probably do a, like a live testing. Yes, of course, there's rotten shark here somewhere, like fermented shark. But yeah, you've seen it already, I think. No, Sarah, there's not all meats are imported. It's more, depends on what it is. Like I said earlier, we grow a lot of like tomatoes and cucumbers and potatoes and stuff like that. So not a lot of importation. For that kind of food. So I'm wondering where the fermented shark. Hi Sarah, yeah, sounds like a great idea of doing a live stream on interesting dishes and just to show you and maybe trying out something. I'm going one more time here to see. I don't see it. Usually it's what the, fermented shark. Am I taking off? Sorry, my gimbal is having some technical problems. Hi Joan, yes, you can buy skyr in the US. There's something called Icelandic provision skyr, and there's also called Sikkis skyr. And I believe there are more, they are growing even more. Ah, harfiskur. That's a good question. In this store, I'm a little bit out of my element in this store, I have to be honest. I should probably be somewhere here inside, but I'm not showing it, seeing it. My gimbal is acting out of control. Yeah, I'm gonna, yeah. So, I think this is just perfect for. The harfiskur, yeah, I'll show it to you later. sorry about that. Skyr with banana, skyr with vanilla, skyr with licorice, all kinds of skyr. So yeah, that was a quick peek into an Icelandic grocery store for you guys. And we'll probably have a live stream later on where we try out something interesting, some Icelandic foods and sample something. And yeah, have fun with that. So I'll see you on Wednesday for the photography museum. I think that's going to be interesting. There are some photographs there that I've never seen. So it's, I think it's going to be fun to see some, so like a, do a time capsule and go back in time and have some fun with that. Next weekend, I'm thinking about maybe going to Mass, like going to church on Sunday. My son has a birthday on Saturday, so I'm not going to do a live stream on Saturday. He's turning 3, Tristi Tir. So I'll not do a broadcast on Sunday. And then the week after that, we're going Northern Light hunting. We're going Golden Circle. Travel from home is 2 weeks from now, where we're going to have like a whole lot of guides from all over the world are going to take you from tours from 10 a.m. to, I think it's 8 p.m. So if you want to take the 20th of March and do virtual travel, that would be a perfect thing to put in your calendar. But I'll see you later on Wednesday for the photography museum. Probably something sooner. I'll probably do something live before that, but see you then.